In 7 years of riding the MRT, Jonathan Derain has endured all kinds of difficulties, long queues, train breakdowns, faulty air conditioning, and roof leakages.
Halos wala din nagbago eh. Na-experience ko na rin na mabagsakan ako ng ano, ceiling.
Derain is part of the riding population that had to endure poor MRT service. According to the Commission on Audit, the MRT sustained over 2,000 unscheduled train removals in 2014. Passengers had been asked to get off the train in more than 200 instances, and services were suspended 50 times due to broken rails or signaling system. The audit agency is questioning the DOTC's failure to sue or penalize the MRT Corporation for its poor service and failure to procure a maintenance provider. Since the maintenance agreement with Sumitomo Corporation ended in 2012, DOTC took over the procurement of service providers, when it should have been the responsibility of MRTC. COA has also raised doubts on the validity of the extension contracts with PH Trams, CBNT, and Global APT. Aside from this, the audit agency also pointed to the inefficiency of the service providers procured by DOTC. COA said the poor MRT maintenance caused one of its trains to overshoot the tracks on Taft Avenue in 2014. MRTC refused to issue a statement on the matter and said DOTC could better provide details on MRT maintenance. Meanwhile, DOTC Secretary Jun Abaya said he has yet to read the audit report.
We have to extend because our main goal is to bring in the likes of Busan. How could you predict failure of bidding? How could you predict motion for reconsideration?
Meanwhile, Vice President Jejo Marbina and Senator Grace Poe are calling for Abaya's resignation because of his inefficiency and poor service.
I've been repeatedly asked the question. I said that serving our people is a privilege for me. And as you know, any privilege could be taken away from you anytime.
President Aquino said Abaya will remain as the Transportation and Communications Secretary. Caroline Bonkin, ABS-CBN News.